Here's some local corporate headlines. Cebu Pacific acquires boutique airline Air Swift from Ayala Land Capital for 1.75 billion pesos. The deal will add 5 turboprop aircraft to the fleet of the Gokongwei's budget carrier. Air Swift focuses on domestic routes to destinations, such as El Nido, Cebu, Boracay, and Bohol. Meanwhile, a consolidation of MegaWorld's top brass as Kevin Tan is appointed board member and executive director of the property firm. He will be taking the reins from his mother, Catherine Tan, who stepped down today. The 45-year-old Kevin Tan previously served as executive vice president and chief strategy officer. And finally, Dito CME clarifies it is seeking to move to a later date its follow-on offering to give potential investors more time to evaluate the opportunity. Davao businessman Uy's telco firm plans to offer up to 1.95 billion common shares at any price between 1 peso to 2 pesos and 15 centavos apiece. Dito is expected to raise up to 4.2 billion pesos from the offering.
Billionaire tycoon Elon Musk makes his first appearance at a Trump campaign. Speaking at a rally in Pennsylvania where Trump was nearly assassinated last July, Musk urged the crowd to register and vote, saying the Republican candidate must win to preserve democracy.
The true test of someone's character is how they behave under fire. And we had one president who couldn't climb a flight of stairs, and another who was fist pumping after getting shot. Fight, fight, fight. Blood coming down the face. Now, America is the home of the brave. And there's no truer test than courage under fire. So that, who do you want representing America? Yeah, absolutely. President Trump must win to preserve the Constitution. He must win to preserve democracy in America. Yes. This is a must-win situation.
Meanwhile, in a separate rally, Trump said he would slap tariffs as high as 200% on vehicles imported from Mexico. That's double from his previous promise as he ramps up his protectionist trade rhetoric ahead of the November 5 elections.
One of the Philippines' biggest IT business process management firms advocates for disability inclusion. Amit Jaga of Concentrix Philippines says around 1.5% of its workforce are PWDs. That's around 1,500 employees. He adds around 3 to 4% of PWD workers at Concentrix also move up the career ladder to managerial posts. Jaga says adjustments in their hiring process, as well as investments in PWD inclusivity trainings and technologies, have brought in a great return on investments. He believes Philippine firms can become more inclusive if they start working with organizations who advocate for PWD inclusion in the workplace.
I think the first step is to create a network. You know, you work with NGOs, you work with special organizations who are focused on training people with disabilities so that you start creating a pipeline and